What's going on, everybody? I'm Drawing Chaos, and we're back with another Satisfactory Designs. That's right. We are continuing in our tutorial series where we're going to be building fuel generators today. On the last episode, we were able to take out the coal generators, made a beautiful, if I do say so myself, coal generator plant for early game, but now we're working on mid-tier, and that's where the fuel generators come into play. Now, unfortunately, this is a bit of a chunky boy, so we're gonna have to break this up into two videos. The first video, which is today, is gonna be focusing on taking the 600 cubic meters of crude oil and turning that into 1,600 cubic meters of fuel. That'll power 132 fuel generators, giving us 20,000 megawatts of power. So, if you want to help me in justifying my decision in making these videos, as well as more, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Shameless self-promotion for the win. But, without further ado, because this is quite a long video, why don't we get into it and see how all this is made. So before we begin, I'm just going to go over the full recipe where we take our crude oil and we're going to break that down into heavy oil residue using an alt recipe, which makes heavy oil residue and polymer resin. That is also going to go into an alt recipe making diluted package fuel. So that's going to take the heavy oil residue as well as the package water to make package fuel. Now you're going to need the packager unlocked because that is where we're going to need the water extractors, water, and some empty containers to make the package water for our alternate diluted package fuel. And then of course we're going to unpackage all that fuel, giving us empty containers to put back into the system. Very nice and simple, all roundabout and all that kind of stuff. That is going to make us 1600 cubic meters of fuel, producing 133.33 fuel generators. And if we calculate that out, that is going to be times 150 megawatts of power, meaning we're producing 19,999.5 megawatts of power, or just shy of 20,000. Now, I am going to bring this down to 132 fuel generators because fuel is not as nice as it likes to seem, and this will run us perfectly and a little extra just for fun. Well, every good build starts with a solid foundation, and of course we have just that, and it only measures a measly 10 foundations by 18, so pretty compact, all things considered. As for the floor, we went with two rows of grip metal, two rows of coated, and then the quarter pipes in the center giving us a nice water channel all the way over there. Then the same thing on the other side with the coated as well as the grip metal. And then we grab ourselves a pipeline junction cross so we can get the water extractors over here on the edge. Now this is why we built on the water, so we can have plenty of room, as well as everything is gonna work out and everything will be right nice in here. Now, as you can see, you can hold control and you can line it up with there, but I want to build a catwalk crossing first. That way, when I go and build it, I can have the perfect alignment on both sides. As you can see, once it changes color, you know exactly where you're going to build it, and then you can build the next one next to it by holding control. And you can do the same thing on the other side so we can get 14 water extractors in a line on both sides. So now that we got the water extractors, let us put a pillar on the coated right here in the corner. Then we can grab a refinery, aim it towards the center, and then we're gonna put it right up against the edge like so. Just match up exactly what I'm doing on the screen and you shall be golden. Now this will give us plenty of room and it'll put everything in the proper spot. We just want to do the first two because we just need the spacing. So when we can go up with the wall, we can actually put another foundation up there. As you can see, we're going to go 6 high, then we're going to grab a foundation, and we're only going to do a 2-meter foundation. Now, this is just for spacing and stuff like that. We will be switching this up just a little bit, but once you have that up, you're going to grab over your catwalk crossing because we don't want this clipping that is up here. So once you got there, you can clip it to the catwalk crossing, then you can grab another catwalk crossing and you can put one over like so. This will give us a little space in the middle and it'll have exactly what we need over here, 2 pieces, and we'll have to do the same thing on the other side. So with that part down, we have a 2-meter one on the outside with a 1-meter one on the inside. And I want to take my small metal pillars and I want to put those on the inside in between those 2 pieces. Now, as you can see with the 1-meter one, it's really hard to do, so it's going to be able to attach to the 2-meter one. But first things first is I want to get the refineries up here. And to do that, I need to build myself a middle piece of a foundation just so I can actually put some refineries right here on the top. Now, when you're putting the refinery, you want them as the green arrows going outward. Now, this is going to have everything going down to the edge. And as you can see, it lines up completely on the edge. So everything comes in from the center and goes on the outside. And you want to match this up with the refinery underneath. Now, you can put a small pillar to get the spacing, or you can just line it up with the smokestack as seen here. Now what you can do is hold control and start building them in a line, delete the temporary foundation we put in the center, and start building the small metal pillars. As well as, we're going to put a upside down inverted ramp 1 meter going down the center, so it gives us a nice single curve. Now to finish the foundation on the second floor, I'm going to grab myself a catwalk crossing so I can actually put something in the center. Now I do want it to be able to see through, so I'm going to grab the glass frame foundation with the straight line going all the way through so I have a nice see-through floor. Now the next thing, I have to go into my logistics and grab a pipeline junction cross and put one at every single entrance to the refineries on the second floor. Then I want to grab a pipeline Mark II and I want to hook up every single one. This will be for my crude oil going forward. Alright ladies and gentlemen, on to a little bit of a tricky bit. See, I want all the polymer resin to come together, so I'm going to take this 2-meter foundation, go vertically, and I'm going to go down 4 foundations. Then I'm going to delete the 3 foundations in the middle. This will allow me to put a merger perfectly to have all the polymer resin come together. So if I go into my logistics and I grab myself a merger, you can see right here, I cannot clip it to the refinery, but I can clip it to the foundation. So if I get rid of the refinery, and this is why we didn't build a whole bunch of them, I can aim it perfectly right here on the edge, just a little bit off, and I have it aiming towards the entranceway, so all my polymer resin can go towards the entrance. And just to make sure that it is in the perfect spot, I can put the refinery back over here, make sure it's all facing towards the entrance of it, and I can make sure that it is perfectly in line with there. Now, as you can see, it looks like it's right on here on the metal, and it's just clipping only just a shy amount, but it still works out perfectly. It looks like it's actually part of the build and looks really good. Then once you copy the pattern all the way down on each and every single one of the refinery, it looks something like this. And then we can start putting some walls into this. If we grab the nice metal wall in the middle part, going all the way across, it'll look really good with those nice cut pieces on the edge. And then as for the center part, what you want to do is you want to grab a basic wall, whatever color you have, and have that 6 meters going all the way in the center. And this will give it a good cutoff part, but it won't be in the way of your nice new line for the polymer resin going all the way around. Then you can play with some colors and see what looks good against whatever color you have for your build. Now this is really good if you want to go in and see what you want to change your refineries to, or you can save that all to the end. All right, on to the next thing. We want to attach the pipes from the bottom refinery to the top. Now, the one thing we want to do is we want to grab a stackable pipeline support, put it right in the center of the refinery, right in that nice little yellow line right there. Then we're going to grab ourselves a pipeline Mark 1. Now, unfortunately, this bottom part, the only thing that really works is a noodle. But when we do the middle to the top, we are going to need this to be horizontal to vertical. And you're wanting to click from the bottom to the top so you get it really close to the refinery and it looks like it's actually attached to the refinery on the bottom. Looks very good. Then when we're done, we're going to delete the pipeline support and repeat that pattern going across. Once all that's done, you're going to want to go over and grab a conveyor lift Mark 1. Now this is going to be attaching the merger to the top refinery. Now as you can see right here, if you do from the merger to the top refinery, it leaves a gap. But if you go from the top refinery to the merger, it'll snap straight to the merger and it'll look very flush and very nice. This is a much better way of doing it and a lot easier too. Then you can grab a conveyor lift, but this time you're going to need a Mark 4, and you want to aim it perfectly for where the out part is, right on that little ways that we left at the edge, and you're going to have it going from the bottom to the top. Now, make sure you have it on not the default mode, but the reverse mode, so that it'll actually go into there. And this will be perfect for when you connect your conveyor belt Mark 4 all the way down to each and every single one of the mergers going all the way across. Now we're going to grab a conveyor lift and we're going to bring this towards the center of the build because we want all this polymer resin to actually leave the build. Maybe we're going to put it in an awesome sink, maybe we're going to use it in a refinery. Who knows? Because the nice thing about all this polymer resin that we're making, which is 800 polymer resin per minute, is we can use it for some other stuff as well. See, it's going to produce us 800 per minute, but if we go to the plastic recipe, you can get an alternate plastic recipe where you take polymer resin and water to make plastic. And the nice thing about that is there's one for rubber as well. So if you need any rubber, this will be perfect for that. And there is actually one for fabric, which is the same thing, polymer resin and plastic. So if you need polymer resin, plastic, or rubber, this will be perfect for you and you'll have it ready to go while you have power being made. Now, onto the packager and everything over here. For the water extractor, you're gonna take a 2 meter foundation, go one in, and you're gonna zoop that all the way down. Then you're gonna go into there and you're gonna grab a pipeline junction cross and you're gonna put it in the middle all the way to the left, right there as you can see on the screen. Now this is gonna work out perfectly when you go and put the pipe in there. Make sure that you don't have noodle on, but go horizontal to vertical. This will give you a nice good slant going on right there. Then what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna put in, if you go into logistics, you're gonna have yourself a splitter. Now make sure the entrance to the splitter is facing the same way as mine's facing and go right underneath the pipeline junction cross, because that's where all the stuff is gonna come down. It's gonna come down from the top and go all the way in. Then you're gonna grab yourself a packager. You're gonna have this going two over from that line. As you can see right here, the corner of the packager is gonna match up with the corner of the splitter. So as you can see right here in the line, go two over, and that's perfectly where we're gonna have it. The same thing on the other side, two over, and perfectly right there. This is gonna give us space in the middle, and we're gonna need that. Next thing up, you're going to want to grab yourself a conveyor belt, and you need a conveyor belt Mark 1 hooking up from the splitter to both of the packagers. Then you can grab a pipeline Mark 1 and do the same thing so that the water extractor is hooked up to both of these packagers as well as the splitter. Now, then you're going to take the packager and you're going to hook each and every packager up to their own individual refinery. Because with the recipes that we're using, we're gonna have packaged water going in each and every one of them. So as you can see right here, we grab the packaged water, and this takes 60-60 to make 60, and this water extractor produces 120, that's why we have two per one. We're gonna be able to make one water extractor versus two packagers to go into two separate refineries. And as you can see from the refinery, if we scroll down to our diluted package fuel recipe, it only needs 60 water per minute. So this is going to work out perfectly in terms of numbers going all the way down. Then we just copy this pattern going all the way down for each individual one, and it'll be perfect. All right, ladies and gentlemen, everything is coming along nicely. Water extractors into packagers. We got the oil into the nice heavy oil residue. And of course, we got the diluted package fuel right here on the bottom. But the next step in the plan is we're gonna take all this package fuel and we are gonna unpack it. But we wanna do that up top so we can use less pumps if we want to. So the easiest way to do that is if you take a wall, you're gonna wanna go up 6 high going on there. And then you're gonna grab yourself a foundation. I wanna use the grip metal towards the top. And I'm only gonna use a 1 meter one. Now, as you can see right here, I have to aim just perfectly, but it is not in the right area that I want it. So I'm gonna build a catwalk crossing yet again. And what I want to do is I want to get rid of this, but I want to have something open in the center for all those nice little things to pop out of. So if you go into architecture, you can grab this frame floor. And as you can see right here, if we loop it going all the way down, those things will pop out of there perfectly. Now I want to grab myself a grip metal one because that's what I have down there. I'm going to go with a 1 meter one, and then I want that going all the way across. And see how I have this attached to the refineries on the top? This is what I want. I want it to look like it's a part of the refineries on the top, so it all clips together, but it is intelligent clipping, I would say. And then, of course, we're going to put the same pattern that we've been putting on all of those, which the patterns are up to you guys on however you want. But half zone one going one way, half zone going the other way. And then, of course, I grab into my colors and I'm going for a nice black and yellow. All right, now we're going to grab our packager so we can unpackage the fuel all the way up here on the top. Now we're gonna be building these in groups of 2 because we're gonna need 14 of these total, 7 on one side, 7 on the other. So to take care of the belts, the first thing you're gonna need is a merger. And the merger is gonna be on the outside, facing outward, so it can go together and go down into the splitter all the way down to the other packager. But for the splitter, we're gonna need that on the inside facing inward so it can actually go for these 2 up here. And you're gonna build these in groups of 2 except for the middle one, which you are going to build spot out. So you'll have 2 packagers next to each other, then 2 packagers next to each other, then 3 packagers next to each other in the very middle. And you'll see going forward. So once you have the top completely built, you can make all of these to unpackage fuel going all the way across the top. And as you can see, they all produce empty containers, which we're gonna need going all the way down. So what you can do is you can attach these 2 together. Then you wanna go all the way down here, and that space that we left over here is very important. Now you're gonna need a conveyor belt mark 2, and you're gonna have this facing up just 1. Make sure it's on reverse. Then you're gonna grab it again. You're gonna aim this one right in the middle of both of these refineries. And then the last part will snap right in so. And it'll look perfect as it's going all the way up there and really flush with the machine. It's gonna be really hard to tell that it's anything special, but it also works really perfectly as well. Then you're gonna connect the conveyor belts to the splitter in the back, and you're gonna want this stuff going all the way down in the center. Now the best part that you can do for this, if you get a conveyor floor hole and put those right next to the pipe, what you can do is you can take a mark 2 again, make sure you get that, and you can have that going straight up and it'll clip right in there. Make sure you're on default for this one. And you can have all your wonderful empty containers going down while the full container's going up. Now, a big thing to note, if you don't like clipping, you can actually put a conveyor lift floor in those nice little metal things. So if you don't like it how it's going there, you can connect just from the floor all the way up to there and then have it sticking out just a little bit right there. And it'll look like it's kind of going into there. That is completely up to you on which one you prefer. For me, I don't mind the metal beam going in between there, but I know some people don't like it. But it's completely up to you. All right, now the way we have it is we have these up here producing fuel with the empty containers. The empty containers go all the way down into those, filling up with water, and then they come back up here when they're full and going all the way down. But onto the next step, we got to connect them from the bottom going all the way up. So what you want to do is go to the floor hole, and you want to go all the way down here in the center part, and then you go up 1, 2, 3, 4, and then clip it off on the side. So now it's coming straight down in the center, it's going off to the refineries a bit, and then it's coming down to loop back inward. Now, unfortunately, we can't have this water just open here just yet. So if we grab another glass frame foundation, we can actually put this in the center going all the way down. And it doesn't matter which way that you put it. If you want to get rid of it later, you are more than welcome to. But if you go back into your logistics, you want to grab a merger and you want to have it facing in the second one going to the opposite direction. And then you're going to go on the other side and you're going to do the very opposite thing. And as you can see right here, this is very important to have it this compact in here. There's no other way that I was able to find to do this, but if you hook it up with the conveyor belt mark one, you can see you can have it going perfectly going one way and perfectly going the other. Then grab a conveyor belt mark two and have it going into the mark two conveyor lifts going up. So you kind of get a nice little yin yang pattern going here together. Then you have two refineries getting merged together going up, and the other two refineries merging together going up for two packagers up at the top. So everything is linked into its own little section, so you don't have to worry about any of the empty crates getting like built up in one area, because they'll all be linked together in their own contained little system. It works perfectly when it works. Next up, time to show you how to hook up all the power poles and everything, because nothing ruins a nice build like power poles just sticking anywhere. So the reason we didn't connect the splitter and the conveyor lift over here is because what I want to do is I want to grab a power pole mark two and I want to hook it up right here next to the splitter. Then I can grab a mark two conveyor belt and hook it down here. And it looks, relatively fine. Then I'm gonna grab my power lines and I connect three things together. The two wonderful packagers down here and the water extractor. Then I'm gonna go over and I'm gonna grab another power pole mark two and I'm gonna keep putting them in the middle of these. Now the reason I'm doing power pole mark twos down here is because once you hook up three of these things together, like so, you're gonna have three out of the four. Then I can hook these over here, but that would take care of all four of them. And I'm gonna need more of them if I want them to keep going in a straight line going all the way across. And the height of it really does help. Now, in terms of the refineries for the center part, if you take the refinery down here in the middle and you connect it all the way up to the glass part right here, you can have this one connected all the way down and it won't be too bad. Then all you gotta do is connect it to the one above it, and as you can see, it stretches the line all the way through the machine, so it's really hard to see. It's gonna work out really perfectly and it won't just have a weird line going all the way out of there. I think this one works out really good if you're building and everything to hide some power lines going across. Now the nice thing about this too is if you're building from underneath, which most people are, you're gonna build the next one in line and you're gonna go all the way up and you're gonna connect this one together like so. But now you need that one above it. Well, if you delete the glass floor, you can actually just connect it real easily going across. And then when you're done, you're gonna put the glass floor back in there. So it's actually really nice and simple going all the way across for the ones down there. Now in terms for the last section that's gonna need power, that is gonna be the packagers on the top. And the easiest way to do that is we're gonna need the center part for something else. So what I wanna do is I wanna grab this little itty bitty space right in here. So if you grab a power pole mark one and get it perfectly in between here, you can have them connected going all the way down. So one right here, then connect that over. And then when you go for the next one, you're just gonna put it right in the center of the next group. And you're gonna continue this pattern going all the way down. Next things next, we're gonna get some pipes up here so we can get some fuel. So if we go into logistics, we're gonna grab ourselves a stackable pipeline, and this will be really good for getting the proper support that we're gonna need going all the way across. So, you know, go in there, skip over four of these lovely things. We're gonna put another one down, and then we're gonna put it over here in the middle. As you can see, this is separated like I was telling you earlier. And then we're gonna put another one over here, as well as another one over here. Now we're gonna need the nice Mark II pipe when we're going across here, so make sure you have that one. And we're gonna put it all the way across. Now, as you can see right here, I can't do it this way because it's just a little too far away, but I wanna put in the pipeline supports right here at the edge. Now, I'll be getting rid of these supports, don't worry, but they're just for spacing out, just to make sure everything is perfect. So if I grab them, put them right here and one right here, I can have it going all the way across. Then I'm gonna grab my pipe yet again and keep connecting all the way down. Now, once all the pipes are built, I'm gonna switch over to the pipeline junction cross, have it nice and flat, and this time I wanna hold control, and if you angle it just perfectly, it'll snap right in front of each and every single one of those machines. So when you connect them, they connect straight across. Thank God they added this, I appreciate it so much. And once we get everything hooked up, we're going to delete all the excess going across, like all the pipeline junction holders and some of the stuff going over here. And this way, we can actually hook up the pipes in each section, and it'll look just nice and perfectly. Unfortunately, it does kind of look like it's flying, but you know, you get what you get. So we'll have this connected over here, and then for the center part, we're going to actually have it curved and going into the center part right here. Now we're going to need these pipeline supports for this one, just so we can have everything perfect. So have it go across like so, and then we're gonna put extra ones right here in the middle. And see how I have the power pole? The power pole will not get in the way, so this will work out very nicely. Once you get it all hooked up, you're gonna have the pipeline support right here, as well as another one right there, and everything is gonna connect right perfectly in the center. Four stacked across, that is why we did not put the power poles in the direct center going across. So I got these on this side as well, so I'll be getting rid of this little excess right here, and then I'll be able to hook all of them up perfectly. And as long as you're following along, you should have it as well. Now this center part, you're gonna wanna make sure you have horizontal and vertical set up, so that one is always gonna be a crucial one. And then you're gonna hook up these perfectly going into there. So this one first, then this one over here, then you're gonna grab from the top going down, and then grab from the top going down, and you'll have this nice little like weave going in here where there is no clipping. Then we're just going to have to take all these pipes, and we're going to have them going across all the way to the very end, because this is where we're going to have all our wonderful fuel generators. Now, unfortunately, it can't reach this far across, so we're going to have to find a spot in the middle where we're going to put more of these pipeline supports. So find a spot in the middle that you like perfectly, and you're going to put more pipeline supports, and then you're going to grab a pipe from over here, drag it to the middle support, and then of course you're gonna drag it all the way to the very end. Easy peasy, and it'll all look good. Now you can have it in the entrance way, or you can have it the exit, depending on which way you want your fuel to go. So we are definitely getting close to the end, and I want to set up the refineries for the heavy oil residue. Unfortunately, these are not going to be fully clocked 100%. We are going down to 71.425%, and this will be perfect because now we'll have a refinery for every refinery underneath. Normally we would only need about 10 refineries, but I like this perfectly because it matches up very nice. Then you can copy and paste them going all the way across. And one of the other things that I want to do is I want to add a little bit of trim up to the top. This will make it look more solid going across, as well as give it a nice little colored look going across here as well. You can do this in concrete if you like, but I like the nice little bit of color. Now it is time to build the entranceway. As we have everything else pretty much done, I want to have a decent entrance for all this stuff to come in. Now you can pick whichever side you want, and I want to do it on this side. So I'm going to grab my catwalk crossing, and I'm going to build a coated foundation going across here. And I'm going to have this going out just a little bit on one side and just a little bit on the other side. As you can see, it kind of matches up perfectly. But one of the other things I want to do is, of course, I want to add a pattern to it. Because that's the theme of the build that I've been going with, is having these nice little patterns and seeing what I can do with them. And of course, I want to change it to our proper color, which is black and yellow. Alright, next up is we want to put some walls over here. So what I want to do is I want to grab my road barrier and I'm going to put the edge of it right over here so I can attach it to the wall that I already put on there previously. And then I'm going to have this going all the way across. It'll be 4 wide and I'll be able to delete the 2 that are in the very center. This will allow me to actually put one in the exact center going across right there, and I'll have that going there perfectly. Now I'll get rid of this road barrier, and what I want to do next is I want to actually grab a hex frame window so I can actually see the refineries on the inside. And I'll go all the way up, but not all the way up, as you can see right here, because I'm going to be using the metal walls later on. Then I can put the basic wall going all the way up to the top, and then I can grab the metal walls that are over here, and I can have them going across the front. But I want to leave that gap in the center because I know something that'll cover it just perfectly. But the next thing that I want to do is I want to figure out how I'm going to have all the conveyor belts going across the bottom. So I'm going to replace this wall down here. If I go all the way to my walls to the very, 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 very bottom, I can grab this 3-hole wall conveyor wall. And this one will work perfectly, right like so. I can hold control and replace the wall. Then let me destroy these wonderful conveyor belts that I put over here, and I'll have it coming across there. Then I can delete the other side and do the exact same thing and have it coming right over like so. Then I want to grab my beautiful pillar and I have it going in just one smidge, as you can see right here. And this will hide that perfect gap that I have up at the top. So let me zoop that all the way to the top. And as you can see, right like so, you won't be able to see anything. And I can grab the small pillar, put it upside down using the rotating wheel, and it is right on the top. Perfect. And the next thing that we're gonna need is a pump. Now, the nice thing about this is we can use a pump mark 1 on this, or if we want, we can switch it over to a pump mark 2. I like the pump mark 2 because it has a nice symmetry, but you can get away with a pump mark 1 for this, no problem. Then, of course, we're gonna take the mark 2 pipeline, put that up there, and use the horizontal to vertical so that it gets that nice, clean look. Then we just want to attach it to wherever it's coming in at, and everything is perfect. Now we have all the crude oil coming in, going up, and getting taken care of. And of course, we're going to have the conveyor belts going pretty much out and over, so we can have everything coming out, and we can use that for another build. Unfortunately, I did not attach the polymer resin to any build over here, because I figure I could take it somewhere else, you know, depending on what you guys want to do with it. Now we just take the power line and we're going to connect it to the other side of this wall. So I just like to delete one of these walls over here. And then when I go around and grab the power line for that, I can just take it and bring it straight through the wall and putting it over here. This works out really good because it hides the line and it doesn't look too bad with the amount of clipping that we have going on over here. Then what I can do is I can grab the power line, bring it up straight to the top, and I want to get it like right in the middle. As you can see right here, you can kind of merge it into the wall so you see it even less. Then you connect these two together and you have all the power lines coming together, looking really good. And it really showcases everything. You don't see any lines going through it and it works out perfectly. Replace your window and you're good to go. All right, one of the last things we need to do is hook up all the power lines together so we can have everything attached. It's a lot easier when we put in the fuel generators, but as you can see right here, I got the same thing going across. And then this basic wall actually goes a bit further than the other one and overlaps on each other, but looks pretty good. Then I can come over here to this one over here, and I can put a small power line over there, connect it to the wall, and then connect it to the center part. And this will get me all four connecting for the center part. Unfortunately, we still need just a little bit more connected up. So right there, I got this one, got that one, and then the two in the center. Now, this gives me everything I need over there, but unfortunately, I need these ones on the top as well. As you can see right here, if I perfectly get it over there, on this area that I click on, if you watch, it actually goes over just fine and looks like it works perfectly. Then I can attach these right in the center. If I get the right spot, it will go down right here. And then I can have them connected up. Now, unfortunately, I can't bring them down here just yet because I need to upgrade this wall outlet to a wall outlet Mark II at the very least. Now I can bring these power lines all the way up there, and every single thing is connected on this whole entire build in terms of power. And we can actually go look at it right now and see how much power we need for this entire build. That is 2,528 megawatts to get this up running so we can produce 20,000 megawatts. So I gotta say, that's not bad. So if we go back in here, there's an easy way where we can have the power coming in the front. So I like to have this over here. If I take my power from the wall outlet that I did over here, I can put it on the pillar and have it going from one side of the pillar all the way to the other. Oh, I gotta make sure I click that. Whoopsie. So yeah, I can have it coming out right over here, just having it going straight through and then coming out on the edge. And this will have all the power coming out in one area. It depends on where you want to hook up the power in your build. If you want to do it in the front or if you want to leave it empty, it is completely up to you. And as you can see, everything is connected, and I just need to connect this over to power. Luckily, I have a lot of power on this build because I built one of these over in the other area. So let me hook it up to power and we'll get everything up and running. Which is really nice because now I can see all the lights to make sure that I have all the recipes attached and I have all the lights going. I know everything is up and running. Now there's just one more thing that we need to do, and that is put empty containers into the build. Now what I like to do is I like to put a stack of 100 in the top just so I know that it's going from the top to the bottom. And the water is getting packaged and put into the bottom before the oil even comes in. So as you can see right here, I have 28 of these unpackagers on the top, and I'm gonna wanna put three stacks of 100 in each one of them. So that is 300 each, so that is 8,400 empty canisters to put in the system. Easiest way to do that is just keep dropping 100, go in a line, and do that three times, and you're good to go. As you can see, they pour out evenly, and you know when you're done, when you can still see containers in there. Woo! All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are done with the first half of the build. That is right, we are turning 600 cubic meters of crude oil into 1,600 cubic meters of fuel. And I would recommend at this point, if you want to change up the colors, see what looks good, all that kind of stuff, now is the time to do it. Now that you got this beautiful looking stuff, and you can start putting the crude oil in there and start loading up on fuel. But for part two, we're gonna have to start working on the actual fuel gens, and boy do I have an awesome idea for that. As you can see right here, I have a really good idea, and I'm gonna be coming out with a second video on how to do this because this one is already too long as it is. But this has been a fun project. Don't forget to subscribe if you do appreciate it, if you definitely want to see more. And you know, we'll get into the nuke one next. I think that one's gonna be really fun to come out with. But other than that, that is going to be it for me, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for sticking around this long. But, oh wait, that's right. I gotta get my cup out for this one. Bye, buddy.